Welcome to the ET197 Automation Studio Quick Start for the Electrotechnical Circuit. Here we are at our Automation Studio, which is within our VMware through the college, and we're going to open up a project or start a project, and we're going to use Electrotechnical NCB. And that's going to be our paper. And let's go to Library Explorer, and we're going to go to Electrotechnical NEMA, National Electrical Manufacturers Association. So let's open that up, and let's go to Power, Energy Sources, and we're going to grab a three-phase, and we're going to grab the three-phase source. We're just going to click it and drag on it. And let's just go ahead and go to view. And let's go ahead and add quick access toolbar, since something changed in the program and now there's small icons. But so we have this one up here. So we're going to zoom window. That's a little larger, better. Okay, the next thing we're going to need is a circuit breaker, a thermal electrics. So let's go to protections. And we're going to go down till we see a thermal magnetic circuit breaker. And let's go ahead and drag that up here and see if we could get them in line, so it would be easier for us to grab our wire. And this one is production device, and we'll say that's okay. Okay, and the next thing we need to grab is our normally open contact. So let's go to, let's close up energy sources, and let's go to contactor poles. And let's grab three poles normally open. And okay. And the last thing we need is a motor. So let's close up energy sources, go to motors. And we're going to use a three-phase asynchronous, which is an induction motor. So here we have an asynchronous motor. Squirrel cage. Good. So we're going to pull that guy over here. And that's all of the things that we need for now. Okay, let's close out of our Library Explorer. And let's take our motor over. And in order to match the diagram we have on our lab, let's go ahead and go to transformation and rotate right. And that looks good. And let's just go ahead and double click on this guy and open them up, and we're going to turn off our star, and we're going to call this guy the internal item identifier. Let's just call that one C1. I think that's going to match our contactor here in a bit, and it looks good. Okay, so now let's go up to home. And we're going to go to wire, just right click on that, and we're going to add to the quick access toolbar. Good. Because here again is giving us little tiny icons, and I don't like that. So we're going to go to polyphase wire configuration, and it should be L1, L2, L3, which is good. Click our arrow, and now we're going to go to polyphase wire, and we should be able to click here and there, and we should get the three-phase wire. Let's right click to cancel out of that, and let's go back again, polyphase wire, good, and right click to get out of it, go back to polyphase wire, and let's go ahead and hook up our motor. And right click out of it. And That looks very good for now. Okay, after I zoom in and make it larger, let's do our control wiring. So let's go back up to here, and I'm going to grab a zoom window. Let's make it bigger so we can see it. And I'm going to move these contacts down because I need to insert a transformer in there. Good. So let's open up our Library Explorer. We're going to go back to our Electrotechnical NEMA, and we're going to go to Control. And let's go ahead and we'll grab our switches first. And I need a push button switch with make contact and automatic. And that's this guy right here. Put it over here, and it's going to ask for an alias. So we're going to call that start. Check our green arrow. And let's take it normally closed. Again, it's an automatic return. And our alias is going to be stop. Okay, good. And we need a relay coil. So let's go down to relay coils. And we're going to move that over here. And he's going to be C1. He needs to match up with our contactors on the top there. Good. And let's see here. What else do we need? We need two grounds and a transformer. So let's go get our transformer. So we need to go back to our power and transformer. Where'd he go? Oh, I'm on control again, sorry. Let's go to power, transformer. And let's take our transformer with two windings. That's going to be our control transformer. We're going to take 208 three phase. We're going to take one of those phases and convert it into 120 single phase. And that's going to be our control voltage. And we also need two safety grounds. So we're going to go to lines and connections. And we're going to go down to potential reference connections. And we're going to find a ground, and we're going to drag it over here. And we're also going to need one for our transformer. So let's drop it over here. Good. So that looks good for now. So let's close out of our library. And let's move these way down here. And they need to also be aligned. That will save us a lot of aggravation. Alrighty, so the first thing let's do is, let's move that down a little bit and move our ground. So let's go to our wiring tools, and we're going to go back up to our top one here, and we need a ground wire. And there's good, right click it, close out of it, and let's see if it, yes, we get two of them, close out of it, escape. Good, so we have our ground, so let's go up here and let's get a power wiring. Whoops. And we're going to use, let's use a power wire. And we're going to hook it up to one of our three phase. That's good. And we're going to go up to the other phase here. And let's escape out of it. So what I've done is I've taken a one phase of our three phase, and I've fed our transformer. Good. So let's go to our control wiring, command wire. And let's go down, and we can work this in 90 degrees. So let's sneak over here and sneak down. There we go. And right click, click, left click, right click to clear it. Let's escape to get out of that. And let's right click, escape. So let's go back up and close our transformer. Good. So that looks like our basic control wiring. Okay, so let's finish this thing up. First thing we need to do, let's go into our transformer, look at our data, and we need to set the primary voltage at 208, which it is, and our secondary voltage at 120, which it also is, so that's good. So these don't have asterisks, so it looks like our links are good. We have one up here, so let's fix our link to this, and we're going to go to variable assignment, and I'm going to let's delete that and show you how to get it. So we should put a C1 in alias to search for it. It's right here. So let's double click on it. And we have our alias down here. So receiver B. So those two should interconnect. Good. That's all of our links that we need to do.